fever is spreading all around with a Geiger counter in.
Hey, I'm Anja Living-Gredal, and today I want to talk to you about the progress of my new outfit, and I want to show you how I made this bra, especially for the ladies, because I get a lot of questions on the tops and bras that I made from girls, so I thought, why not, let's make a video about it. I will show you my outfit, like what I'm wearing and what I'm working on. It's like, well, you have seen this perhaps before. I wore it at a photo shoot, but it's still not finished and it's way too high, so I need to cut it here and make this longer so I can pull it down a bit more. I'm working on a new harness, and I will show you in a minute why these are so really nice to have to if you work on an outfit, because everything that I make I put on my body first before I attach it together with nuts and bolts. So yeah. So that's why. Let's see if we can fix it again, like bloop. Well, let's stand up. Trousers that I'm still working on, I need to attach these still. Here needs to happen a lot more. Let's see if we can. Oh, pink socks, always important. So,
is spreading all around with a Geiger counter in my hand. I'm going out to take me some government land.
Uranium fever. So yeah, stay tuned and see how I make this. So here you can see the details up close. I always start with grunting this. I have a tutorial on my YouTube how I make these. It's really easy. What can make and break an outfit? Because this already looks, you can leave it like this, it already looks good. But I think adding details just, it makes it interesting. I think that's the word I'm looking for. It makes it more interesting to look at. I think this already looks cool, like a hole. But if you start adding small details like this, I think even though perhaps you won't see it on a picture, I think in real life, if people are just looking at your costume, these are the details that makes it just a little bit more interesting. Yeah, here, this is where I ended. And I just used simple acrylic paint for it. And it's quite easy to do, so here more. And not sure if it's a realistic weathering, but frankly, I really don't give a shit. I'm more about the aesthetic than realistic. I like it, and if I like it, I just do it. I do not want to, like, some people are like, well, that's not, yeah, it's not, it, this is not real. This is not how something would look like. But to me, post-apocalyptic is also a fantasy. Just do not, it's what actually, if you do know Dimitri, he has really good videos on this, like, do not limit yourself. And it's true, do not limit yourself. I totally agree with his videos. Just do whatever feels good to you. Like, I think this really adds to the costume. Another thing I want to talk about is a lot of people ask how I make these things, and I can show you in a bit what I did. But they also ask me to if I want to sell my gear, but there's a reason I don't, and I will show you, because I'm not a clothing designer. First of all, I'm not really good at it. I'm just doing this for a hobby and for fun. And the second reason, like, I have no fucking idea. I have no idea how patterns work or how to finish something. So this is what the inside looks like. I find it most important that it doesn't irritate my skin, because you have to wear it all day. And this doesn't irritate my skin, because I already tried and I have already worn it for half a day. And that's also an advice: wear your outfits before putting it on at a fair or event, because wear it at home for an entire day and then you know what itches and irritates and what not. I have learned the hard way, because let me show you. This material, it's in a tube and I love to work with it, but this, when it's a sunny day or it's warm, this starts to irritate in your neck quite a bit. So I have another inner tube top. It's my first one. Oh, toss that one aside. This was my first, and my friend Linda helped me with this one. This, I did this at a festival, because it's my neck, so I just ripped a piece apart and put it on this, like, I've put it on here like this to stop irritating my neck. So, and another thing that I have learned, like, really, really test your outfit is this piece. I have worn this to Dutch Comic Con like 2 years ago, and I almost had a nipple slip. It was my nipple was like up there or something, but it was starting to go down even more. But my boyfriend noticed in time, so he dived at me and grabbed my boobs and saved the day. So I also do know why, because I attached this to a bra that I got from a secondhand store, but the material is too heavy for this bra, so every time I moved it went down a bit more. I know guys of you probably won't complain, but no, just no. That's not something that I want to happen. So be aware, so really test your gear, especially when it comes to bras. And if you're a girl and you don't want to have nipple slips like I do, just test it. It's a really really important. So let me see if I can tell you how I make these. Well, I'll be back in a minute. Stay tuned. So I do not have time to exactly show you how I did it, but I can tell you how I did it. First of all, these, perhaps you have seen them on my Instagram, on my pictures. These are really come in handy when you make an outfit, because before you attach anything permanently, you can use these clamps to just attach it, and then you can use nuts and bolts to attach it to the other part. So when I make a costume like this, I always start with this. This is the base that goes around your waist, and this is how it looks like when you start. It's just in a tube. And when I go to the secondhand shop, because everything that I made is done cheap. A lot of people think I spend a lot of money on my costumes, but I don't. I really do not spend a lot of money on it. You can get these for free at bicycle shops, because they throw them away, and you can ask them if you can take them with you. So that's like the sport of this. Well, it doesn't have to be a lot of money. So this is what I got at, like, a whole bucket full of belts. Like, sometimes I buy 10 or 20 belts at the same time for like 20 cents or something, so keep it cheap. You have, I think the best part about this, you have materials like a leather or fake leather, whatever you want. And also this. This is what I want. And you can cut them off, like not here, but here. So let's see if I can find one. So, actually, oh, I have to do this with one hand. You make, punch a hole in here. This thing goes through the hole. And then you can fold the rest around it. And then this will be here. And you can take... Not sure if I can do this with one hand. Oh, close up. Like this. And then you attach it with nuts and bolts. Not forget to punch a hole, because you really need this, because this not only for punching holes over here. Like, I readjusted this one. I needs to be pretty close to the base. And you also need this one to punch these holes. And that's how easy it is, actually. And a second, you want it around your neck. And I think the best way to do this is just to do this on yourself. You can help a friend to ask a friend for help, but I am doing this alone, so that's why these buddies are the best you can have when you do things on your own. Then you need to attach this one. It goes around your neck, and actually the same. Well, you've got this base now. Blah, be gone. Just place it around your neck like this. You can do all in front of a mirror. Like, need two hands for this. See what I just did here? Then you have the base. And this is around your neck. And it's a really good start for any harness that you're going to make. And then you, again, punch some holes in it. Get some bolts and nuts. And do not forget to put these behind it. Or else they will go through the material. Like, did I use, like, these things. Because it's rubber, it does stretch a lot. And after you made the base, like, floop, this one and this one, you can attach anything that you want. And I still suggest to do this while you are wearing it. So this fits your boobs perfectly. And I just attached this one. Let's see where. Oh, like these. I also got from secondhand shop. So, and I actually did the same with this. Like, where is the beginning of it? No, that's the end. Like, fold it around. Grab this body over here, and put whatever you want to attach it. Like again, like I said. Nuts and bolts, and you can put it on there. And same goes here, attach it here, like I did, and build it up. And last but not least, I added some tires. Just also use tires from from a bicycle. I have no fucking idea. And this this used to be a candle holder that I had for many years. Like the rest of it is here. Use whatever you like, what you want to add to your costume, and that's how easy it is. And then do not forget, because a lot of people forget, to distress it. And it makes or breaks your outfit, so really do not forget to distress it, because, well, you see the difference already. I think it adds a lot to your costume. So, if you make your base, paint to do whatever to it, and add some details, you can put, I don't know, whatever you like. Some people like runes on their costumes, so you can put runes on here. I've got Tribe Riot on here. But do whatever you like. That's actually how I do this. And this, I know this, also a thing that I think works is to not work too carefully. Because normally this should go on the back and it would look more like this and it would be more neat. But I think by doing this the other way around, it just adds to the costume. Do not think, it doesn't have to be perfect. That's what the word I'm looking for. So this same. This isn't perfect at all, and I think, again, that adds to the costume. So, yeah, that's how I made my top. I get a lot of questions on how I make my bra, so I hope this helps a bit. Yeah, you can probably can do this a lot better, but again, I want to show you this because it doesn't have to be perfect. So remember, distress it and wear it at home. Test it a lot and, well, you'll be fine. You see the difference? Like, all black, shiny and chrome, and then bang, post-apocalyptic. So, yay, thank you for watching. I hope you learned something. Oh, and to answer another question that I get a lot, it's about my makeup and how I do my makeup. Looks like this, and you do this, and you do like, this makeup trim, what the fuck does it called actually? I have no idea, it works. So that's what I do when I do my makeup. Like, make yourself dirty all over the place, and will also make or break your outfit. Trust me.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.